Hello. Today I need to tell you a story. So I need to confess you something. I'm not a framework man. What it means, it doesn't mean that I don't use them. It means something really simple. I've always felt oppressed in my creativity, been frustrated by using such framework. So I've always wanted, when I design an architecture, when I create web application, design a system, to make it the way I want me it to be done, and I want the tools, the library, to support my use case, my own use case, and not the other way around. One of the areas where I had so much frustration was reactive web application. And I've used very nice library, but each time I had to make some compromise. There was some pitfalls or drawbacks, developer experience, performance, accessibility. So I didn't always found what I would like to have. So, but I had to change my mind recently. So I found something a couple months ago, and I had to be as open-minded as I was when I first saw React or I first saw Angular. So I had to keep this open mind. This is called Svelte. So I'm quite sure most of you know Svelte already or have heard about Svelte, but I will show you just a few things. Svelte is also a component framework. It's a framework that helps you to write web application, but in a different way. It's not a runtime framework. It's a language. So it defines the conventions how you will write your application, and then it will compile this application to vanilla JavaScript and CSS. So it's how it works. It's a compiler. It's not a runtime framework. And how you produce a web application with it. So that way, you will create components. And, well, this looks like something familiar. I think the first part is JavaScript. Yes, looks like JavaScript. Then CSS, well, yes, it's CSS. And something like that looks like the DOM. You have a variable, and you expect this variable inside the curly bracket to be replaced. So how it works, ooh, it's fancy. So I can use that component and have it the rendering from my component. But it's not reactive yet. So to have something reactive, let's take this variable, level, and we will be able to bind this value of level into an input. Here it's a range. So I'm expecting when I change the value of my range, this value to be adapted. There is a span. The value is added into the span. So I'm expecting this value to change when I change my input. It's what it does. Not really, it's a GIF, but it does it on my computer. And it's not yet completely reactive. Reactive means double data binding. So here you have this alien syntax, these weird things with the dollar colon. It's actually JavaScript labeled. And it helps you to re-render the variable height each time the reference on the level variable changes. And how it works, here you will see the class is applied, the volume is in red. So again, it's not fancy, but it's reactive. By convention, you can create double data binding. You can do it for one node or for 2,000 of nodes. And it's the point of, if you have saw Twitter, you saw that thing. So Svelte has also a lot of feature built-in which have changed my mind. Accessibility, CSS is included in the framework, state management, motion animation, transition management. You write less with Svelte, and I think it's the future. So thank you. The best way to predict the future is to do it by ourselves. So thank you very much. Yes.